Ladies and gentlemen, this is Joe's Classic Video Games back with another really cool arcade game video for you this evening. This is actually a pinball machine. It's Williams' famous, well-regarded 1975 Space Mission. Really cool game. I had never played one before until we started working on this one, and let me tell you, it is fun. This is a good game. I'd always seen it and heard people talk about it. Oh, I'd like to get a space mission, blah, blah, blah. But I'd never actually played it myself. But here it is, live and in color. So let's check it out. Again, this is a 1975 Williams. In pretty good shape. Look, we got people outside trying to come in to play it. See if they come back. I don't think they will. All right, 1975 Space Mission it was in pretty rough shape actually whenever we got it, but the playfield is pretty decent. The back glass needs a little work, but it, you know, it's decent. And the cabinet was so-so, you know. Whenever something's 40 years old, they've seen a lot. Won't say it's been abused, but it's seen a lot. So there's this side. This side has that kind of chalky thing that they get sometimes where the paint gets kind of faded. It literally, it's kind of like it turns chalky. But the artwork's cool. It's kind of like a space station or whatever, I guess. I suppose. And then here as well. I don't remember. I guess it's not a space station, it's a rocket. I don't know. Someone research that for me, will you? I hope it's American. I don't want to, you know, be showing off something from the Soviet Union or something, but I guess it's got the American flag on it. Maybe we stole it from the Soviets or something. Anyway, cool game. Cool artwork. This side's in much better shape, even though it has a couple horrible gouges there, but other than that, it doesn't have the chalky thing going on. Nice stenciled work there. So it's got cool cabinet art. Williams Space Mission. Usually that would be much more red. That's all faded over the years, unfortunately. But what can you do? There's really no way to repair that. I mean, once it does that, you can't make it red again. But so if you get one that's in excellent shape, that will be red. This is such a popular game that they actually remake this back glass in all of its full color glory. So if you wanted to make this machine really nice, you could buy a brand new back glass for it. On some of the really popular games, they actually make replacement back glasses. One player, 64,000. So it's kind of, you can see what's going on here. Here we have the rocket stage with the solar panels out, I suppose. As I understand, this back glass was based on a painting. I mean, was a painting based on an actual photograph. Makes you wonder how they would have taken such a photograph. So maybe it was maybe the back glass was based on a painting. Got the planetscape down there, which I would assume is Earth. But very cool. Man, it's a space theme. I mean, doesn't get much more cool than that, does it? And it's from the 70s, right? Think how awesome this would have been in the 70s. So we'll check out the playfield. Very fun game again. So again, you've got this stage of the rocket represented here in the middle with all of the bonus ladder on it. They call that a bonus ladder because you count up it basically as you play the game. The plastics are interesting as well. This one also has like a satellite on it. This one over here has a rocket firing off. This one up here has an astronaut.
This one up here also has an. Whoop, this one up here also has an astronaut. Here's another one with a tether. They're out working on the capsule or the ship. It's pretty sweet artwork. And here they are inside the capsule doing their thing. I would guess that's like an Apollo capsule, but I don't know that for sure, so I don't want to offend anyone who's really into aeronautics. That would be my guess. So, interesting things about the playfield. A couple pop bumpers that look nice. You have this neat little horseshoe shot up here. Basically, it goes in, comes right back out. And that hits what they call the super bonus advance, which advances your bonus 5,000 instead of 1,000. So you've got your advance bonus switch here, and then there's one in the middle there, too. And then this middle rollover is an advance bonus. So it advances this ladder up, you know. And this rollover switch up here is an advance bonus. And these ones on the side also do. There's a little stand-up switch there and a stand-up switch there. If you hit any of those, the bonus goes up. Click, 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 click. And this one, basically, you can get a ton of points on this game. Ton of points. Whenever you get it up to 10,000, it starts over again and runs up again. And then you can like 20,000, it'll start over again. You can run it up again. So, I mean, it's got just, you can get a ton of points on it. It's also got these little shots. It doesn't have slingshots. It's got actual kickers down here. So if the ball lands in there, it shoots it out, and about 50% of the time you will actually hit this target, which is a swinging target. It's got a motor on it, so that thing moves constantly back and forth, which sounds real simple, but it's really fun. I don't know why, it's just cool, because you don't ever know if you're going to hit it, and you might hit it by accident, or if you're aiming at it, it might move, or it's just cool. And then you've also got two saucers, one on this side, and one on this side that the ball can land in and pop out. And then you've also got a spinner. And all in all, there's a lot to do, a lot to shoot at, a lot going on. You can get points here, get points there. And the game just plays pretty fast. It's got a lot going on. And then at the end of it, each time, you get this insane bonus that gets to count down. And you can even light this double bonus win lit. Awesome. Or same player shoots again, win lit, so you can get an extra ball. To get the extra ball, all you have to do is when this lights up, go through that center rollover switch, which actually you can do pretty easy. Once the ball gets back up there to the top, it bounces around a lot from these pop bumpers and it'll go up the wrong way many times. So let's read the instructions, because you know that's always more fun if you know how to play it. Insert coin and wait for machine to reset before inserting coin for next player. Check. This is a four-player game. Each player shoots one ball at a time as indicated on the back glass. Check. Tilt penalty. Ball in play. Tilt does not disqualify player. Gotcha. Making A, B, or C lights the eject holes. So basically, I don't know if there's another way to do it or not, but the only way I saw to do it was if you hit the swinging target, you know, you get whatever scored. Well, if you get both of these, it lights up B as you move to 5,000. So if you get two in a row, basically, and you have to, because basically it won't move unless you do that. So if you hit both, it'll light up one of those. And so if you do that, it lights the eject holes, which means if you land in there, it'll light up that light there, which means you'll get a double bonus when lit. So if you land in there, it turns on the double bonus light. So lights double bonus when lit. All right. Eject holes when lit light the double bonus, as we just explained. When A, B, or C is lit, position a swinging target light, increases spinner value, and lights extra ball rollover lane at top of playfield. position of swinging target light. Okay. So if A, B, or C are lit, it will also turn on the extra ball light at the top, and will make the spinner, instead of worth 100, worth 1,000. Making A, B, and C, which basically you do by hitting that so many times that you basically work all the way across it, lights bottom rollover lanes alternately for one extra ball. This is the special when lit. You can also set that where you get a free game when the special is lit. Maximum one extra ball per ball in play. So there you go. So we've talked about it, but I will set up the tripod and we'll play through it, and you'll see just how fun this is. Again, I'm not a great pinball player, but this is a good one for novices, and it's also a good one if you are a good pinball player, because you can just score so easily on it. Now, by the time these came out, this 75, they had a lot of adjustments on them, so you can actually set this as very conservative or very liberal, where you can make it, where it's easy to gain a lot of points, or it's really hard to get a lot of points. So I, of course, have it set on EZ because I'm a novice. But we'll set up the tripod, and I'll show you what it's like. What a cool game, man. It really lights up very, very nice. Very nice. Very, very nice. So we'll play through a little bit, see what you guys think. There's a little bit of a glare because the glass is on it, but oh well. All right, all my scores reset good. Here we go. Whenever we film these videos, we're still kind of testing them, too, to make sure everything works right before we advertise it for sale. Check out that swinging target. It's so stupid. I mean, it's just so silly. It just goes back and forth, but it's so fun. That's so cool. Actually hit it. There we go. The spinner's cool. If you look, whenever it spins, it looks like the rocket's taking off. Oop. Sometimes if it goes through that top super advanced at the wrong time, if it's doing something else, you won't get the score, the super advanced, but that's because of the way it's designed. It's kind of a flaw. Oh man, I want that extra ball. There we go. Same player shoots again. I just noticed this light didn't light up. The one on the back glass did, though. Oh, you can't see it because of the angle. All right, that was the first ball, and I got a free ball, so I'm still on the first ball, and my score is 81,000 points. That's ridiculous. Whoa. Skin the cat on that one. Oh. So that's pinball for you. The ball is wild. First ball was 81,000. Now after the second ball, which was a free ball, 90,000. So I got 81,000 points on the first ball and 9,000 points on the second. Oh, not enough. You
You can also, if you, another little thing you can do is if the ball's going slow, you can catch it and hold the flipper like that, and it'll actually roll down the flipper into the launcher. Oh, lost the bounce. All right, so I got 109,000 points. That's pretty good. I probably won't top that. That first ball was awesome. Ugh. Horrible. Well, no, I was going to try to, yeah. Saved it. I had it lit up like Christmas too. We're at 47,000. Ask me again. All right, we'll play one more game. Outlanes are a killer, but really this it's a long ball time game. I mean, you get a lot of play for a quarter. So there you go. That is William's Space Mission. What a cool game. The two-player version of this was called Space Odyssey. And it's basically the same game except two players. Super, super cool. I like the way it lights up and stuff too. It's just got a nice look to it. Plays cool. And again, it's a really high scoring game. After you roll it over on these Williams, like after you get up to like, you know, I'm at 39,000 now. Once you get up to 100,000, there's a little light that lights up beside it that says 100,000, and then you add that score to the 100,000. But very, very cool. Very, very fun. Great game. I would suggest getting one if you get the opportunity. You'll enjoy it. And it's also, like I said earlier, has some, you can set different settings on it to make it more liberal or conservative in regards to scoring. So you can make it where it's a lot tougher than it is. I've got it set on easy, which means I can just rack it up. And to be completely honest, whenever we sell them to people for their house, that's usually how they want them. They want them so that you can get the highest freaking score possible. So somebody will really enjoy this game in their house. Now, by the time you see Space Mission, it may have rocketed over to its new home. May not even be here anymore. But don't fret. If you're looking for an arcade game, just check out our website. We've always got all the ones that we have available right now, like this nice Pat Hand that's next to it. We've still got here in the showroom. We've got all the ones that we have available right now, mostly arcade games, but we usually have one or two pinball machines in. Available on our website at lionsarcade.com. So even if you're watching this video 20 years from now, go check out lionsarcade.com, and it will be up to date. And you can see what we have in right now. We keep it up to date daily. Or if you're local, you can stop by and see us in person. We're in downtown Rock Hill, South Carolina. That's about 15 minutes south of Charlotte, North Carolina. And we've got a whole showroom here just full of stuff for sale, arcade games. Or maybe you're not local, and maybe you don't want to buy an arcade game, or you don't have room for a pinball machine, or whatever, but you just enjoy these videos. Well, that's cool too. We enjoy making them. So subscribe to us here on YouTube, and every time we get one done, it will send you a little email telling you that there's a new video so you can come and join the fun. So we will see you on that next video.